Here it is, the Turntable HiFi system with speakers from Buy One. Apparently this system allows you to wirelessly play your music. Also have, of course, two stereo speakers, and it allows you to adjust the tracking force of the playing head. And the last but not the least, it allows you to convert vinyl record to digital audio file, which is one of the reasons I bought this system. Let's see now what's in the box. This is how you receive it. So it's quite compact box. See my hand next to it. It's quite a compact box for what it's supposed to deliver. So they put everything in this small box. Let's see what's in it right now. All right, opening it. The Rishendal system. I call the Rishendal because inside the box we have another box. So let's remove that and see what's inside the small box. So here we go. I cheated a little bit because it was not easy to remove everything on camera. The box was quite heavy. Basically this is what you see now. It's upside down what was the content of the box. I didn't touch anything except just removing it upside down. So that was the top of the box, and we go up to the bottom. So that was at the bottom of the box. All right, so let's start from the bottom since we are here. So we have first the disc itself, the turntable itself, the quite heavy parts, one of the quite heavy parts. So the disc itself, very nice brush metal, look like painted black, looks nice, feels heavy, but that's normal for this kind of device. And it comes with a mat that you put on the top like so. So this put on the side for now. Then we have, and I think I will have to flip that. Here we go. So that's the device itself, I should say. All right, so let's try to open this thing without damaging anything. So I guess this pull on the side. This is the plastic cover that cover your turntable when you don't use it, or even sometimes when you use it to avoid dust. So here we go. This is your nice plastic cover from Buy One with the logo right there. I don't know if you can see it. All right, so nice plastic cover. Resuming the unwrapping of this device. Here we go. So well protected, fortunately, because as you know, all the shipping company, they play football always with your package, so it's better to protect those delicate electronic very carefully. So removing this block that protect this turn panel, and here under the turn panel here there is another foam here you have to remove. So always double check all the little foam there and there. Will avoid some bad surprises when you run your device. Put that there. It's like an air cushion. It's interesting. It's like it's some air cushion here. So that's the motor right there where you put the belt. Some assembly required. I just let you know, guys, right there. Don't think that you open the box and that's it. Everything is good to go. Now you have to do some assembly on this turntable. Here also there is like a little twisty here. So to unlock the arm, and also there is some tape here for the head. All right, so I'll just leave it there for now. I'm going to finish unpacking and check this, set it up later. Right there, I want to show you though the outputs, the connector from the back of this turntable. So you have the speaker, the connector for the speaker, classic connector. And then, which I like, it has a USB port here. That says PC, USB port for PC, on and off button, power here. And then it has some RCA connector here. and you can choose phono or line here. There's a switch here, but that's for the back connector of this unit. Okay, so now back to the main box that was on the top of the box I opened first. Now opening this last box. All right, so they give you some warning sticker here that says attention, accessory 1 of 2 and accessory 2 of 2. So there is this little slit here and here that warn you there is some accessory there. So that means when I remove the speaker, there should be accessory stuck into this polystyrene. So don't throw away the polystyrene before to check for the accessory. I can feel them already. Here we go. Like I told, the speaker almost out of this polystyrene. One had nothing but what I can see, but the second one had the accessory, like they said. So the user manual, the belt, it's here. And here we do have some more accessory which look like the power block. And there is a counterweight here. And a cable for the speaker to connect the speaker and the USB cable here. So everything is there, nothing else. Now let's see those speakers themselves. All right, here are the speakers now without the plastic around them. See, they look really like this nice old style. I like the old style mixed with modern technology. So that's what we get here with those little rubber foot to rest nicely on your desk. So here are the two speakers next to each other. Here we go. Excellent. So now the only thing to do is follow the instruction manual, which is right there, and see how to set up this turntable right there. That's pretty much the whole look right there. So putting the belt, setting up the counterweight here, and then removing the protection for the heads, and then do the first test. Let's see how it sounds like. It's right now.
Here we go. First step first, you have to install the belt on the motor and then on the small disc, which will be sitting under the main turntable disc. Next step, you put the big turntable disc over the small one, and that covers the belt, the motor and the small disc. And last step, you put the mat over the turntable disc. Like so, here you go, and now you are ready to go for this step. And of course, don't forget to remove this step that holds in place the cover of the turntable head. So during transportation, they put this step to avoid the little plastic cover to fall down and damage the head. So remove that and then you will be good to go. And now is the time to find in the accessory bag provided with your turntable this counterweight. So it's very easy to install. You just put this counterweight in the bottom of the arm of the turntable. Then you unscrew it counterclockwise until it reaches the maximum of the tread. Time to remove the plastic protective of the head now. We are going to do a balancing of the arm. So unlock the arm and then you put the arm away from its base. And you have to screw or unscrew the weight, the counterweight, until the arm is completely balanced. Like you see here, it's it should stay horizontal. No matter if you push it down or pull it up, it should stay always horizontal. That means it's well balanced. And now time to install this little counterweight, which will avoid the head to bounce on your disc. So follow the user manual. It will tell you which slot to tighten this nut, depending on the head that you have installed on your turntable. So the factory head have a specific setting that I will tell you in the user manual. Now it's the time to connect your cable to your speaker and the turntable. So be sure to respect the polarity to put the red in the red slot and the black in the black slot. Once done, you have to verify that each cable is well secure and there is no loose contact. Next step, you have to install the plastic cover for the turntable. And that's it, you're all ready to go now.